Something that I haven't heard you talk about before is this system called, this alternative election forecasting system called the 13 Keys to the White House. Perhaps it's a little bit sadistic to force you to explain what this is, but could you explain what the 13 keys are?
So the 13 keys are a system by Allan Lichtman, who is a professor of government. I don't know if he's a professor emeritus, retired now, at, I believe, American University in Washington, D.C., which I think are an example of kind of the replication crisis and kind of junk science. Or let me kind of, so, you know, one problem you have in election forecasting that's unavoidable is that you have a small sample of elections, right? Since American elections began voting in the popular vote in 1860, before that you would have state legislatures appoint candidates, one election every 4 years. So you have a sample size of, what is it, you know, 22 or something like that. So when you have a small sample size and a lot of plausible outcomes, you have a potential problem that people in this world might know called overfitting, which is you don't have enough data to fit a multi-parameter model. And there are different ways around this. I mean, you can, I don't know, I don't know if you want to get to a modeling technique per se, but the keys to the White House is a system that claims to perfectly predict every presidential election dating back to, I don't know, the 19th century based on 13 variables. There are a couple of problems when you try to apply this forward-looking. One is that a lot of the variables are subjective. So, you know, is there a significant foreign policy accomplishment by the president? Is the opponent charismatic? These are things that if you know the answer already, you can overfit and kind of p-hack your way to saying, okay, now we can predict every election perfectly by when we already know the answer. It's not that hard to predict, quote unquote, correctly when the outcome's already known. So when the election's moving forward, then actually Allan Lichtman will issue his prediction, but it's not obvious. You have to wait for him to come on stage or come on YouTube now and say, here's what I predict here based on my judgment. So he's, you know, it's a judgment call, a lot of these factors. Also, he's kind of lied in the past about like whether he was trying to predict the Electoral College or the popular vote and shifted back and forth based on which was right and which was wrong. But he's a good marketer, taking the system that's like, you know, just kind of punditry with some, you know, minimal kind of qualitative edge or quantitative edge and trying to make it seem like it's something more rigorous than it is. He says, for example, that Donald Trump is not charismatic. By the way, he's a liberal Democrat, and like, I'm not a fan of Donald Trump, but like, he literally hosted a reality TV show. He was a game show host. I think there's a certain type of charisma that comes through with that. And like, and that's the one thing he probably does have is that he's, you know, charismatic, maybe not in a way that a Democrat might like, but you know, he's a funny guy. He's an entertainer, literally. So kind of, I don't know how you wouldn't give him that key, for example. And look, it's not a terrible idea to say, let's just take a whole bunch of different frameworks and kind of average them out. Like, that's not actually such a bad idea. But you want heuristics that you build in ahead of time that you don't then have to apply subjectivity to. Even for forecasters, I think an election can be an emotional affair. You can have a personal preference for the outcome, or you can get invested in your forecast where you probably stand to gain more future opportunities if your forecast is perceived as being right. So you want to set up rules in advance that you're not allowed to change later, more or less, unless something's like literally broken. If you're building like a, you know, the silver bullets in election models, like, you know, several thousand lines of computer code. If we caught some actual bug, then a minus sign instead of a plus sign, then we'd have to own up to that and change it potentially. By the way, that model was already wrong this year because it said that Joe Biden would defeat Donald Trump, and Joe Biden was losing so badly that they had to quit the race. So you have a survivorship bias problem too in evaluating this forecast. In some ways, it kind of fits a stereotype of what an expert is supposed to provide you with. If you go and look at like best-selling nonfiction books, every subtitle is like the hidden factor behind X or like the secret factor behind X, right? So like, it's a very well-marketed system where it's like, I, the expert, am going to reveal these secret keys that, and you put them together and you unlock the White House, basically. Whereas for the silver bulletin model, it's like, yeah, just a you know, a fancy average of polls, basically. And like, actually, it's a very hard problem statistically because of the way polls are correlated. And there's lots of things you have to figure out. But yeah, just the polls, basically. And we're never going to be certain. We're just going to be probabilistic. It's like actually kind of harder to sell to the mainstream, I think.